1971 to 1974. Strat-O-Matic Excel Carryover League. Brought to you by the Shrimp Trawler.
Game 554, Rockies and Astros.
Welcome back, baseball fans, the 1971-74 Summer Carryover League. We are back today in the National League. We have a series between the Rockies and the Rockies and the Astros. The third place team in the Mountain Time Zone against the second place team out west. That would favor the Astros most of the times. And boy, certainly he still does. No aberration here. Let's go take a look at where the two franchises are as we meet. So the Rockies find themselves in third place, five games under 500. Houston's a couple games over 500. They played the Giants rather lousy in their previous round, unfortunately. Got knocked out of first place in a second place. And then the Giants continued to play well to win the division. So Houston's a nowhere land. Can't really catch the Giants anymore. Now they got to settle for a wild card, but you got to get there first. And getting there means getting past the Rockies. Two over 500, five under. That's a difference of 3.5 games. Five games to decide these two teams. Winning four out of five is not quite enough for the Rockies. That still puts them a half game behind, but it forces a tiebreaker. So they would need to win five of six. So that means that the moment they lose a game, I'll broadcast. Since I always broadcast the first elimination game if it comes up. Well, here we are. Game one opening up in Houston. It is Al Fitzmaurice for Colorado. It is Larry Durker for the Astros. You don't score off Larry Durker, you got no shot. You don't score off Larry Durker. He gives up two hits, four walks. Durker, one of my favorite pitchers in this timeline, is a magnificent 69 card. Like Marichal, he had fantastic years in 69. Now he got his 70. What year card are we using right now? Actually, we used 72 Durker's 15 win card. Same result, though. Domination. Astros get enough. As the Rockies single walk, two base error, wild pitch kind of inning. And that's all the Astros would need. 3-0 victory in game one and only. That means the Rockies kind of going through the motions here. They got to win five straight. They got to win game two in Houston, come back home, win 3 and 4 in front of their home fans if they can get to their home fans, go back to Houston for a game five, and for good measure, stay in Houston for a game six. So yeah, that's the path. Doesn't seem likely. We've seen one team do the five out of seven. That was the Giants. We've seen one team do a 6 out of 7. That was the Detroit Tigers. Those teams are put together a little bit better than the expansion franchise, Colorado Rockies. Today's starting pitchers for Colorado, Dick Dragostash, 72, nice year. 12 wins and a 3-1 ERA for your Kansas City Royals. And for the Houston Astros, Bob Johnson, acquired in a trade for Jack Billingham in the offseason. 71, Pirate. Would have gotten a World Series ring for those 71 Pirates. Anyway, 9-10, 3.45 ERA for Bob Johnson. Drago Johnson from the Dome, 8th one in the world. Let's get started. Leading off for the Rockies, it'll be Rick Monday today. His first leadoff in a while, 63. He rolls back to the mound. They juggle the lineup. Trying something, get a spark going. Don Money, 1-3, flies to right. And Terry Crowley, 47, single 1-6, lines out. The Toy Cannon, Jim Wynn, 56. Triple, 1-3, is a base hit on a 4. B Steeler, he won't go anywhere. It's Joe Morgan. 54 off the Drago card, homer, 1-11, double. It's going to be a two-base hit. Toy Cannon No, not right now. Second and third, let's just stay put. This could be a huge inning. You don't want to get thrown out when you could blow the team out in the first inning. Bob Watson. 46, single, 1, 2, 10, and he rolls a 10 for the single. RBI, 1-0, runners on the corners. Cesar Cedeno. The wrong key there. Cesar Cedeno, 36, is single, 1, 2, 5. He lines out. Runners on the corners with one out for Jose Cruz. Two H's a walk. Bases are loaded for Danny Cater. Pitch to Danny Cater. 2-2, pops to second. And with two outs, Johnny Edwards. Big at-bat here for the Rockies. They need a break. They need to get out of this inning. But they cannot. 2-9. Let's take a look at John Edwards' card. 1972 to 268 hitter. As a left-handed hitting catcher with power. 2-9 is triple 1-3. Double the rest. It is double the rest. Jose Cruz. Oh, he'll run. 15, 16, 17, minus 1 is a 16. Scores exactly on a 16 because it's Houston's world and they're dominating these Rockies. Now, we have seen Houston. They've been all over the place this year, folks. We saw Cleveland bury them 27-8 in one game or in a couple games. I can't remember. And then they fought back and they swept the Padres and they got beaten by the Giants. They're just up and down, up and down, up and down. You never know what you're going to get, but you got the up right now, folks. Four runs in, runner at second, two outs for Roger Metzger. 3-6, base hit left field. Johnny Edwards, a 10 runner, 11-12. He's going to take on the 12-0 arm, and he's out on a 20, as is everybody. So, well, four runs in the first. That should be enough for big game Bob Johnson. Rick Auerbach. 1-9, base hit. J.C. Martin, 3-10, flies to right. Dave Kingman, 37's a K. And with two outs, it's Don Mason, 38, single, 1-13, and he gets it. Two on, two outs for Andy Costco. 2-5's a strikeout. Bottom of two, it is Joe Haig, 63, first X. 3-22 for Kingman, that's a single. The Toy Cannon back up top here. 2-3, short A, double play ball. And with two outs, Joe Morgan, 47. Base hit. Morgan's going to steal. He's a double A stealer. He's in there at second. Do we get a T rating? We do not. Morgan's at second with two outs for Bob Watson. 3-7's a walk. Two on, two outs for Cesar Cedeno, the All Star. 64. Third X, but you got a great defensive player there. Don Money's a 188 at third base this year. Makes the play. Well, the Astros have been putting a ton of guys on. They've scored four times. Into the third. Joe LaHood, 48. Right. Rick Monday, 46. Walks. Don Money, 411. First X, good defensive player. A 2E4 first baseman, Joe Haig. And that is your GBA. Astros have an answer for pitching, defense, and plenty of offense at this point. In the bottom of the third, it's Jose Cruz. Rounds of first. Danny Cater, 46, single 1-10, gets it. Johnny Edwards, 1-8, walk. Nice day for him. Two on for Roger Metzger, 2-8, pops the second. And with two outs, Joe Haig, 66. Oh boy. Double 1-2, single that dot. My goodness. On the corners for the Toy Cannon. 2-12. That is a ground ball to short plus, but there's, you know, holding that guy. Okay. 5-0 already. And the Rockies look listless, being outscored 8-0 in 12 innings thus far. Terry Crowley, 1-5, flies to center. Rick Auerbach, 38. Well, J.C. Martin, 1-6, is a fielder's choice. He's at first with two outs for Dave Kingman, 4-11, first X. And again, at first base, is that 2E4 first baseman, and that's an out. Bottom of the fourth, it's Joe Morgan. 2A, let's take a look at the Joe Morgan card of 1971. He's 2-for-2 today, folks. He played pretty crappily all year. Was benched in the previous series, but He's having a good one here against the Rockies. He's doing better. Right as they start to think about trading this dude to the Cincinnati Reds. 71, a 256 average, and 88 walks. Oh, that would be... He could easily do better than that Cincinnati in both those categories. 13 homers as well. And a two-second baseman. Oh, he could be better in all those categories. He will go to the Reds in the offseason. That will be one of the big moves, the biggest move. But right now, 2-8 in his last stint with the Astros. Double 1-11, single dot dot. So he is really on fire now. Trying to turn a crappy season into something special here at the end. He's going to try a stolen base. He's in there, doesn't get the T rating again. Runner at second for Bob Watson. 48's a K. Cedeno, 37 is a walk, two on for Jose Cruz. 47 is single dot dot. And oh my goodness, these Astros, they got a clicking today, folks. You know, if they can somehow find some consistency, just not, you know, the sine wave of wins and losses, just stay on the winning side of life, these guys can roll with anybody. Danny Cater, 43, first X. This is Kingman, who's a 3E22. I don't have to look any more. First baseman, E4 makes an error. He makes an error. That's how we do the home field. It's getting ugly here. First and second, one out for Johnny Edwards. 46 is a single. Loading them, one out for A. Bunning Metzger. I got to bring it up. 6-11, left X. Oh, boy. A 3-9 for Joe LaHood. And he plays that into a single dot dot. Two-run single. We'll give this guy two more batters. Joe Haig, 49, single one line out. Maybe it's you guys, folks. Maybe it's YouTube. When the Astros have been on YouTube a lot of times, they've been incredible. Jim Wynn, 4-11, left X. 3-9, LaHood again. And LaHood, he makes the catch and the inning's over. The Astros actually were also no hit on YouTube by Bob Gibson, either last year or the year before last. So they have that on their resume. So yeah, they're all over the place. 9-0, the girl with a curl. Four innings of Dick Drago is more than enough. He'll leave. Already making the move from the bullpen. But top of the fifth of a 9-0 affair. It's Don Mason, 38, single 1-10. He lines out on a 13. Andy Costco, 37's a K, and with two outs, it's Joe LaHood, 63, pitcher B. Bob Johnson has a two-hitter through five frames, and Larry Durker threw a two-hitter in game one. 9-0, Rocky no-show here, no surprise either. Bottom of the fifth, let's pause a moment for station identification.
This is the Shrimp Trawler video channel.
Este es el canal de videos de camaroneros.
All right, bottom of the fifth, Klimkowski is in there now. Ron Klimkowski doing the pitching after the bomb of Dick Drago went off. He was an Oakland A in 71, 2-2 with a 3.40 ERA in 45 innings. Here he comes in the face, Joe Morgan. 46, flies to right. Bob Watson, 67, double 1-6, misses it. And Cedeno, 2-6, another base hit. Jose Cruz, 55, second X. 2-E-30 at second base, makes the play. We go to the sixth. It's big game Bob Johnson against Rick Monday. 2-7 is a strikeout. Don Money, 49, single 1-6. He gets it. Terry Crowley, 35, 6, 4, 3, double play. What a debacle, folks. Bottom of the sixth, Klimkowski continues. It's Danny Cater. 56, short X. Shortstop is a 4E44. That's Rick Auerbach, and that is another error. My goodness, Colorado. Johnny Edwards, he is 2-for-2 plus a walk. Some RBIs today, 2-6, fielder's choice. All right, he's at first. Oops, for Metzger. 1-6, another fielder's choice. So he's at first with two outs. For Joe Hague, 1-4, and that's the end of the inning. So nice job for Klunkowski, two scoreless frames. Top of the seventh, 9-0 affair. This thing's flying by. We haven't even gotten to have a cup of coffee and find out more about these Rockies. Let's take a look now at a couple guys. Here's Rick Auerbach. Take a look at this guy. 74 Auerbach, just 73 at-bats, but he hit .342. So you need these cards on these expansion teams. And I'll tell you why. There's not a lot of these cards in the league, guys who hit .340 in the short sample. But these expansion teams need as many of these guys as they can get just to keep up with the Joneses, you know? Unfortunately, there's not a lot of Rick Auerbach cards in this lineup, but he leads the club in hitting, and he will hit away. 312 strikeout plus injury. Well, there you go. Okay, let's see. Let's get Gagliano in here, and Mason will go play short, maybe? Gagliano play short? Like Gagliano. Yeah, Gagliano can play short, I think, right? Ugh. J.C. Martin, 2-8 is a K. And with two outs, Dave Kingman, 2-6, single 1-13. Oh, my goodness. Can we get a hit? Nope. My goodness, what a debacle. 9-0 game. Boo the Rockies for not showing up. And the Astros are loving this. Stretch time here in Houston. We're listening to Gene Clark's 1974 No Other LP. Some Misunderstandings, a big one off of this one. Silver Raven and No Other, Strength of Strings. Great record by Gene Clark. Great little studio production here. Kind of flew under the radar with this one. The critics didn't sell a lot, but the critics liked it, I think we want to say on this one. Okay. Klimkowski, nice job. Let's get out of there after a couple frames. Jim Merritt will come on in the seventh. And Merritt was a Ranger in 73 with a 4.05 ERA in 160 innings. And he will try and shut these Astros down. It'll be Jim Wynn leading off. 54 pops to short. Joe Morgan, same thing against the left side as a pop out as well. Bob Watson bounces to short. Looks like the Astros have more than they need. 9-0 into the eighth. Big game. Bob Johnson pulling a Durker. That's what he's doing here. He's Durkering these Rockies. That's an expression for shutting out the Colorado Rockies. You Durker them. Because that's what Larry Durker did in game one. Well, Bob Johnson's doing the same damn thing. It's Don Mason. 37 grounds to first. Andy Koska. Let's take a look at this guy. So here's your typical Colorado Rocky card. They go for homers, walks, and of course strikeouts. They don't want to hit in double plays. They don't want to steal bases. Tag up, go first to third. Hitting in double plays. They just want to force you into 27 outs. And maybe they'll get a three-run homer along the way. But they need three-run homers, and they have five outs to get it. So there you are. Andy Koska, 34, flies to left. And Joe LaHood, 69. Oh, it's a double. Up Bob Johnson. Rick Monday trying to wreck the shutout in the eighth. 49 is a single to left field. LaHood. He's a 13, 14, 15. He's going to run off the toy cannon arm. He's in there. Now they're going to hit Johnson's point of weakness with Don Money. 47 is a walk, and they do that. So now we've got two on with two outs and a 9-1 affair. And Bob Johnson will leave to a smattering of applause there. Outstanding effort. Runs out of gas with four outs to be made. Not a big deal, we don't think. We'll go with Mike Cosgrove in the eighth. He will face Terry Crowley, or he will face a pinch hitter for Terry Crowley, which will be Jack Hyatt. Let's take a look at Jack Hyatt. Longtime backup catcher, known for high on-base percentage. You know, the same kind of thing I mentioned about Costco. Homers, walks, strikeouts. 35 walks, 174 at-bats. A .276 average and probably a .400 on base for the Astros, is the team he's playing. What a platoon with Johnny Edwards. Johnny Edwards, the current Astros catcher. So they're on different teams today. So Jack Hyatt, two on, two outs. Here's the pitch. 4-5 off Cosgrove is a fly ball to right field. All right, bottom of the eighth. We'll go Jim Schellenbach in the eighth, an appropriately named Colorado Rocky pitcher. I knew nothing about this guy other than that name, and it said Schellenbach. That's got to be a Rocky pitcher because he's going to get shelled. But actually, he was good for the Rangers in 72 with 3-4, the 3.47 ERA, and 57 innings. Pretty good pitcher. He comes in here to watch their Rocky season end, more than likely. Cedeno in the eighth. 46 is a double. Joe Cruz, 1-3, pops to short. Danny Cater, 2-12, fouls to the catcher. Defensively, Doug Rader will fill in for him. And batting for Johnny Edwards, it will be the trivia question. How does an old lady account for her gigolo? And the answer is Dick Billings. Let's take a look at Dick. He is a Ranger in 72 as well. He would be teammates with Schellenbach. And old Dick hit 254 with five homers and 469 at-bats. Big moment here. Runner at second and two outs. The pitch to Dick Billings. 37 is a strikeout. We go to the ninth. Cosgrove needs three outs. His defense is in there. It'll be Phil Gagliano for the injured Auerbach. 56, short X, but you got the gold glove of Roger Metzger. No problem there. You got J.C. Martin has to bat because, what's his name, got hurt. 410, center X. Cedeno's 0-1 in center field. He makes the catch. And it's all down to Dave Kingman. Let's take a look at Kingman. This was really one of his best cards. It wasn't a full season. It was only 115 at-bats, six homers, and a 278 batting average. I think he had that same batting average in 79 when he hit the 48 bombs for the Cubs. Or was it 288? I can't remember. But an excellent card for this timeline, as he's only going to hit 210, 220, 230 over the next few years. The pitch to Dave Kingman. 48 off Cosgrove is a walk. And they are still alive for Don Mason. 1-9 flies to right field, and that is your ball game. The Astros finish off and eliminate the Colorado Rockies, who are probably fortunate to not be in last place, let's face it. Cosgrove gave up just a walk. The victory for big game Bob Johnson, five hits. That run that was earned. Three walks, six strikeouts. Schellenbach, a hit and a K. Merritt, three up, three down. Klimkowski, a hit. Bullpen was fantastic. It was Dick Drago. It was awful. 13 hits and nine runs. Oh my goodness, this is an ugly looking, oh boy. Seven earned, four walks, strikeout. My goodness gracious. So, break up your Houston Astros. Two straight easy wins. That will improve their chances greatly in the third round of the tournament to go into the playoffs as a wild card. We'll look to that in a moment here. 1009, 0108, 915, 15, 4642. If you're wondering about the competition, the level of good teams and bad teams playing each other, you have to be reminded that these two divisions did not play before the All-Star break. So other teams in the other divisions already had their crack at beating up on the Rockies. So, you know, don't start poo-pooing these Astros for the cupcake they just drew. We can actually look at the Rockies' schedule briefly here. We'll do that just to see who they would have played in the other divisions. Take a peek at that right now here. So let's go to schedule. If you're wondering, so here's Colorado. There you go, Atlanta. So, like I said, Atlanta, it's the year of the Atlanta Braves. They're number one seed. Well, they drew the cupcake, Colorado. Toronto, well, Toronto's having a great year in the American League. The Cardinals, well, the Cardinals are having a great year in the National League North. So that explains, that can explain the success of those three squads. And then, of course, the other three are divisional. So that's just a quick little peek there to suggest that, you know, the Astros finally, you know, and the Astros, well, we'll take a look at that too. They had a tougher path. So Houston had to deal with the Cincinnati Reds and the New York Mets, the two best teams in the National League a year ago, and the Cleveland Indians, who have a winning record. And the Cleveland Indians still have to play in this round. They're 6 over .500. Or maybe, no, they might be. They're 7 over .500. So, yeah, the Astros had a really difficult schedule. So it was about time they got a cupcake here in the Colorado Rockies. So the Astros are now 20-16, hitting 247. Don't like to see that. 340 ERA, like to see that. Larry Durkert, love him. 8-3, four complete games, 28 runs and 95 innings. I'll get you a 265 ERA. Bob Johnson, 6-2. Seven saves for Frank Lindsay. Home runs, you got the Toy Cannons, got 11 homers. He was in the All-Star game. 31 RBI, leads the club in both categories. Only had two stolen bases, which is interesting. He had 14 bags by Morgan and 14 by Cedeno. Cedeno won the All-Star game. 43 for 140. Cedeno at 307 this year. So, yeah. Good Astro baseball club. Good team. Don't trade Joe Morgan to the Reds. Don't trade Jimmy Winaway. Hold on to these guys. Wait for J.R. Richard and Joe Niekro and Joe Zambito. And, yeah. Astros were really one of the better Strat-O-Matic teams that historically only had a division title in, what, 1980. But if you play a lot of Strat-O-Matic in this timeline, you'll find out you can do very well with the Astros. Good pitching and great defense and speed, in my opinion. Let's take a look at Colorado here. They are now 16-23. They hit just .230 with a .407 ERA. Actually, the ERA is good for them. It's the batting average that stunk up the joint. And the All-Star was Mel Queen because he had 8 saves. A lot of times we see closers go to All-Star games for lousy teams because all they do is get saves in the 9th inning. And you generally win a 30-year game. So, yeah, he saved 8 of the 16 in this case. Only 8 home runs to lead this club, and that was by Andy Kosko. 25 RBI. Just these numbers aren't very good for the offense, really. No sluggers here. Not even a lot of walks. You got 29 walks for Rick Monday, and nobody else is 20. That's just bad. 2016, 16-23, yeah. Let's plug this result in. Houston, check this out. So this is pretty remarkable. In this slot a year ago, I don't know who Houston would have played, but Houston was in that slot, and the result in that slot 1 year ago, in the year 2022, they won 2 straight, 2-0. They did the exact same thing, 2-0. I don't have to erase anything or write anything in there, so I had to leave it alone. And they were 21-16. They're just off by one game. They're 20-16. Rather incredible. Oh, they beat the Florida Marlins a year ago. And it's the Colorado Rockies who fall to 16-23. But the Astros at 4 over .500 is only one more series in the National League to play, and it's this one here. There's a very high chance that Pittsburgh and Philadelphia may play this so that both teams advance. That's because the Cardinals, the Padres, and the Astros have all won. And notice the difference in games over 500. You have 3, 4, and -2. So all Pittsburgh or Philadelphia have to do is stay out of -2. So if Philadelphia wins 3 straight, Pittsburgh's at -2. So the Padres need Philadelphia to sweep the Pirates 3 straight, or the Padres will be sent home because they're 2 games under 500. And the 4 and the 3 and this result here, the 1 and the 2 playing each other in the best of 5, only half game back. Looks like it's going to be Pittsburgh, Philadelphia, St. Louis, and Houston is what it looks like. I don't think the Padres are going to last. But the 4 over 500 is very key here. Let's go here and plug in some results. I'm going to put Houston right here. This is the top team. This would be 5, 6, 7, 8. So for right now, I'm going to put Houston here. I'm going to put St. Louis here. 4-3. And in the Pittsburgh, Philadelphia teams, unless the Phillies win like 3 games to 1 and also get to 4 over 500, there's a reasonable chance that Pittsburgh and Philadelphia will be in this configuration in some way. And I don't think the Padres are going to be the number 8 seed. So that's it tonight, folks. Pretty quick, easy destruction of the Colorado Rockies by the Houston Astros. Break up those Astros. Thanks for checking this out. We'll see you next time.